first time that I met Daddy was in 1959.
I was at the University of Miami, and I was the photo editor for a magazine that was called Tempo. And I didn't know anybody down there because I was fairly new. I had to select a girl of the month and then take her pictures so that she could be in the Tempo magazine. So they had a Hurricane Honey contest. I sat there and I was a judge and picking out Hurricane Honeys. Nancy came through and, oh my goodness, such a beautiful girl. You know, such a beautiful girl.
And he called up and he had this beautiful deep voice that was very mature.
And I said, I'd like to take some pictures of her and make her Miss Tempo.
And I thought, oh yeah, I'm sure, you know.
Well, love, love you, darling, come and go with me. Don't let me way beyond the sea. I need you, darling, so come go with me.
I think maybe your mother thought I was just another guy trying to call her up to get a date. It wasn't, you know, so I took her and we went out and we took some pictures.
And then I went and I found out that it really was on the level and it was the truth. So that's how I met Daddy.
I love, I love, I love my calendar girl. Yeah, sweet calendar girl. I love, I love, I love my calendar girl. Each and every day of the year.
I think 7 of the last 10 finalists were from the University of Miami, and Mom was one of them. I had to take her picture for the magazine, Tempo, that it was on. And so that way I got to see her mother over and over again at all these different things.
I remember him helping me on with my gloves for that event. I just thought he was really something.
Well, I love you, Kel, and I want you, Peggy Sue.
They had a talent thing, and your mother just played the piano so beautifully. The girl that won it just did the Charleston. I couldn't understand it. I thought they were crazy.
Pretty woman, walking down the street, pretty woman. The kind I like to meet, pretty woman.
Just went out, got a hamburger at some hamburger joint. It was a drive-in, I remember.
One thing that impressed me so much about Daddy back then, he focused on what he wanted to do. He went through college in 2 years, plus he was working 40 hours a week. So he and I never really had time to date.
And then I finished college and I got a job and I was gone for quite a while.
Down the way where the nights are gay and the sun shines daily on the mountaintop, I took a trip on a sailing ship, and when I reached Jamaica, I made a stop.
Really didn't see your mom that much. We only went out, you know, that one time, that was it.
Won't be back for many a day. My heart is down, my head is turning around. I had to leave a little girl in Kingston Town.
Bum, 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 bum.
Your mother was engaged to somebody and I was engaged to somebody. And then we both broke those engagements.
After I broke up my engagement, I thought, who do I really want to be with?
It's a lover's question I'd like to know.
I immediately thought, Ron Beck. I was kind of afraid to call him because I had heard he was engaged. But then he said, guess what? I said, what? He says, well, I'm no longer engaged.
I'd like to know.
We talked and then he says, well, how would you like to go out dancing over in Miami Beach? And I said, wow. And that's when we went out dancing.
Have you met Miss Jones?
Daddy took me dancing, swept me off my feet, and do you know what? We didn't go dancing again.
I would say we did dance a lot. It's kind of like a little restaurant bar that we used to go when they had a jukebox. And we'd always play Have You Met Miss Jones by Frank Sinatra. That was our song.
I lost my breath, and all at once was scared to death. And all at once I owned the earth and sky. Now I'm at Miss Jones.
Now your mother would probably say that we didn't dance enough. But I felt we danced quite a bit.
He fooled me about the dancing. Not that he wasn't a wonderful dancer. But I don't think he really cares about dancing that much.
All at once I lost my breath. And all at once was scared to death. And all at once I owned the earth and sky. Now I've met Miss Jones, and we'll keep on meeting till we die. Miss Jones and I.
After I graduated, I had to come back to Indianapolis because my grandmother was ill and she was dying. And so I got a job with United Airlines.
Come fly with me, let's fly away.
Had to go through 6 weeks of training. And one of the reasons I did that was because I thought, how am I going to ever see Daddy? He's in New Jersey and I'm in Indianapolis. So I thought this will be great because I can go see Daddy, I can go back down and see my friends from the university.
In Llama Land, there's a one-man band, and he'll toot his flute for you. Come on, fly with me, let's take off in the blue. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied.
I bid on Boston, and I would trip trade with other girls so that I could go to Boston to see Daddy. And I would have to go there and come right back. It was a turnaround. And Daddy would meet me at the airport. I'd have maybe a 3-hour layover.
I'd see her on Sunday mornings, and I'd see her on Thursday nights. On Sunday, we always toured Boston. And then Thursday nights, we'd go out to dinner. I lived in Arlington, and always tried to be there in Boston. Just did that for the longest time.
There she was, just a walking down the street singing.
Do what did it, dum did it do?
Tapping her fingers in.
after a while, I got a new job, and they moved me down in New York City. And so I was sharing an apartment with Charlie Ferrugia, 200 East 27th Street, Manhattan. The company I worked for, their headquarters, was in Chicago, so I kept going out to Chicago for meetings and everything. Whenever I'd go out there, I'd meet with Mom. And your mom would take flights into New York, and I'd see her when she came to New York.
The purpose of a man is to love a woman, and the purpose of a woman is to love a man. So come on, baby, let's start today. Come on, baby, let's play the game of love.
Charlie and I had an apartment, and we were having a party one night, and I called your mom up in Chicago, and
I decided that if I got married, I was going to marry Daddy. And so that's what I told him.
We decided that we'd get engaged that night, you know. So then we got engaged, and Mom moved to New York, and she had to find an apartment. So in all of Manhattan, she's looking for an apartment, and lo and behold, she's sharing an apartment just catty-corner from us. You know, we were like on the southeast corner of 27th and 2nd Avenue, and she was on the northwest corner. It was difficult because we kept trying to plan the wedding. My family lived in New Jersey. Nancy's family lived in Indiana, and we were living in New York. I would drive your mom out to the airport whenever she had an early flight. A lot of times Mom was late. And this one morning, I got up like 4 o'clock in the morning, got the car out of the garage, brought it down there. I'm sitting there waiting for her. She comes out and she's late, which meant that I had to race out to the airport. I got real mad and I said, well, if we don't get married today, we'll never get married. And she says, well, let's get married today. And she called the airline, said she was sick. I drove over near Times Square to an all-night bookstore and bought an almanac to find out where we could get married. And I found out we could get married in Virginia. There was no waiting time. Then we drove over to Newark Airport, and they had these planes that flew every hour on the hour from New York to Washington, D.C. And we got to Washington, D.C., we rented a car, and then we wanted to get married by a minister, and we called all the churches. They all wanted to make you wait 3 days. So finally, I walked back in the office, and I said to the woman there, I said, what good is this marriage license? You can't get married here. Everybody wants you to wait. She says, well, there's an attorney across the street, and he has the power to marry people. So we went across the street, and we got married.
It's very clear our love is here to stay. Not for a year, but ever and a day. The radio and the telephone and the movies that we know may just be passing fancy. And in time may go, but oh my dear, our love is here to stay. Together we're going a long, long way. In time the Rockies may crumble, Gibraltar may tumble, they're only made of clay, but our love is here to stay. That we know may just be passing fancies, and in time may go. But oh my dear, our love is here to stay. Together we're going a long, long way. In time Rockies may crumble, Gibraltar may tumble, they're only made of clay, but our love is here to stay. Telephone and the movies that we know may just be passing fancies, and in time may go. But oh my dear, love is here to stay. Together we're going a long, long way. Time the Rockies may crumble, and Gibraltar it may tumble, they're only made of clay, but our love is here to stay.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They're like much more. And I never knew, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry, I watch them grow. They're like much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're saying, I love you. I hear babies cry, I watch them grow. They're like much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Oh, yeah.
Okay, now, gang. You're clear now. See, I can't see to focus.
Well, where are
we? Okay,
right,
you're good, aren't you? Huh. Okay.
Can you sit down here?
Now, Ronnie, what are you going to do? Are you just going to sit there and make faces? I want you to sing a song, Ronnie. Okay, Moms. Now, taking a good picture of yourself there. I think I'm going to drop it.
Where do I hold it?
Drop it.
Okay.
Right. Okay, now, put your hand down here. Uh-huh. Okay. Now, whatever you see Ronnie in there?
Yeah.
You gotta get him in there.
He's in there.
He's in there? Okay, Ron, I'll tell you what we're gonna do. Now, let's sing a song. What? You know Old MacDonald? Huh? Old MacDonald had a farm. E-I-E-I-O-O-O, and on his farm. Come on, look at Mommy up here. He had some ducks. How does a duck go, Ronnie? Yeah, how does a monkey look? Can you stand up here and just give me a little bit of the dance that you know how to do? Come in. Go, Grease Lightning. Go, Grease Lightning. Daddy's getting a little chubby, isn't he, Ron? Yeah, I guess he is. I think Mommy's doing a real good job.
Peek-a-boo!
Well, look at Mommy. She's the pick-a-booer up there. Hey, Ron, let Daddy do a monkey. I think you can see him. Oh, Mom.
In there, Daddy. Are you in the picture?
Mm.
Now, come on, say something. Look at Daddy. Don't look at the picture. Look at Daddy, because you can look at the picture later, see? You can look at the picture whenever you want to, but the thing is now, look at Daddy. Look at Daddy, because you can look at the TV later. Ronnie?
Peek-a-boo.
Look at Daddy, Ronnie.
Peek-a-boo.
Look at Daddy.
Ronnie, look at Mommy. You
Peek-a-boo.
Are my sunshine.
Peek-a-boo.
My only
peek-a-boo.
Sunshine.
Peek-a-boo.
You
peek-a-boo.
Daddy, I wish you'd do Robert Goulet. You're doing like somebody's on your foot. I wish you'd do Robert Goulet.
I held you in my arms. How about a kiss? You got a kiss for that? Oh, that was a good one. A kiss there?
Daddy, sing on a clear day.
I don't know a clear day, Mommy. On a clear day, you can see forever. Mommy's trying to make Daddy a TV star. He just doesn't have it. He just loves it. Pupsky's in this wild man here. Hey, what's with you? Look at Mommy. Why are you always looking at TV set? Look at Mommy. Look at Mommy, Ronnie. You can see the TV later. Look at Mommy. Oh, you're so vain. You're so vain. We'll save this for posterity. That's what you get for being that way. Hi, Debbie, don't do that. What do you want to do that for? I'll put that on your head. What is this? What are you doing? Oh, who's that? It's a goose. It's a goose. Oh, it's Ronnie. I thought it was a goose.
Peek-a-boo. Oh,
she's a great aunt. What? Whoa, Peek-a-boo!
Woo!
Okay,
Mom. Don't get me
out. Oh, there's Mommy. Mommy's going to sing us a song now. She's such a good singer. Ronnie, you think you can get Mommy to sing a song?
No, there's no way.
Where's Jennifer, Mommy?
Around somewhere.
Debbie, do you know where Jennifer is? What are you eating?
Crackers.
Crackers? Oh, Debbie, you a cracker eater. Who's the king on his castle, huh? What do you do? Well, say something, Ron. Daddy's the only one who talks. Is that the way you talk? You better watch out or your bottom's going to get in the picture again.
No, then your bottom will get in the picture again. No, then everybody will see your underwear.
Oh, yeah?
And everybody will pull down your underwear. Turn it up. I want to hear how we talk.
You do?
Now, there's our Jennifer. Jennifer, are you going to smile?
You've got to hit back. You're cutting off her head.
Are you going to smile? I'm cutting you off. Jennifer, say?
Oh, there now. Oh, yes. She likes her pacifier. We're trying
to move.
Keep it out as long as we can. So you can see her pretty face. Okay.
There's your pupsky. There's a beautiful family if there ever was one.
April 29th. And whose birthday is it today, Ron?
Daddy.
Is it Daddy's birthday?
Yeah.
Yes. And whose birthday was just 9 days ago, huh?
Jennifer.
And where is Jennifer?
Right.
Is that Jennifer?
Oh, 9 days
old. 9 days. Our new little pumpkin is just 9 days old.
Okay, now I'm going to take another look at old Jennifer here.
Dad, turn it up. Dad, turn it up. Turn it up, Dad.
Lift her up. Okay, Debbie, your turn. Yeah. Oh, that was Debbie sucking.
Hello. Hello, everybody. How are you?
Hello.
Hi.
How did
you
do? Oh, you're getting to be a big girl, aren't you?
Go down your grass.
Yes, you are.
How do you, everybody? How is everybody?
Not fine.
They're not fine? Well, that's all. Ronnie's been out playing in the sprinkler. He's going to go get some dry clothes on now.
What?
I think it's about time.
What's today's date? What is today?
July 20th.
1979.
Yeah, 1979. Terry.
Hi, dear.
Oh, show your dimples.
What is that, Deb? Oh, boy. Oh, Debbie gonna look pretty in that. Hey, Ron, how you doing over there? Oh, who's that in the background? Is that Jennifer over there? Yeah, this is Christmas 1979. This is her first one. That's right. That's nice, Debbie. That's beautiful.
In the letter, it's a puzzle.
Well, you're a pretty serious space writer, I'll tell you. How's Jennifer doing over here?
You can open it,
sweetheart.
You can open it. It's yours.
That's right, Jennifer. They yelled at you for opening them. Now they want you to open them.
Teddy bear.
Jennifer. Who's under the paper?
Jennifer.
Okay, today's Christmas Day. Come on, Ron. Ronald says it isn't Christmas Day.
Ronnie's been making the baby laugh.
This has he been making?
Yeah.
Jennifer did.
Grandma Beck is here with us.
Jennifer, are you giggling? Your brother makes you giggle, doesn't he?
She's growing. 1979.
Sure is.
Christmas Day, 1979.
Christmas Day, Thanksgiving Day,
but everybody else is celebrating Christmas.
You're not there,
Shippy. I'm
living.
You want to
kiss
the tell-all?
You
hold
the plate.
No, I have to. Yeah, I'm going to go. Hey, you know, Ronnie, Ronnie, bring one of your toys here so we can see what it is on TV. Show everybody
my foot here. Oh, daddy. Gotta get his shoes on all day. We had a great big turkey dinner and we couldn't eat pie.
Couldn't even eat the pie.
Okay.
Delicious
anyway. That's
just
the pie.
Oh.
Fork, he goes,
I got a camera that goes with her. And I got a more talking space pack. And I got this.
You got that.
Jennifer got that.
Yeah, Jennifer's birthday is tomorrow.
No, you're opening her present.
I know, I'm giving her present.
It's Ronnie's birthday.
Well, that's because he's sitting in the shadow. I told everybody they got to sit up.
We can't see you. No, you need to get over by between Debbie and Jennifer, honey.
Go sit by the red chair.
Yeah.
How's that, Mommy?
Yeah.
Everybody good? And they clear? Are they clear? Okay, Jennifer. Jennifer, look at Daddy. Hello there, Pupska.
Don't put it in your mouth.
Oh, now, come on. Can't Jennifer have her birthday?
Before you put it in.
Oh my, Jennifer, you got lapped with a pacifier there, didn't you?
I already got the power.
That's
perfect.
Yeah.
You can dip it in
there. See those stubby legs? Oh boy. Oh, that's that nice bathing suit that Grandma House bought her for her birthday. Yeah. Oh, look it. Jennifer! There she goes. Oh, that's pretty! That's pretty, Jennifer.
Yes, look what you got there.
Can you say daddy? Daddy? Say daddy.
Daddy.
Stop looking at yourself on television, Jennifer, and say Daddy. You're looking at yourself on television. Yes, who is that? Who's that on television? Yes, that's Jennifer. That's Jennifer on television. Yes. Look at her. Oh, that won't fit you. Oh, you're going to play with that baby? Yeah, you're going to go play with the baby on TV, huh? Oh, look. You're going to go play with the baby on TV, Jennifer?
Yeah.
You want to play with? Oh, no, you want to come over here. Okay, I think... Happy birthday, Jennifer.
Happy birthday.
You seem very interested. Happy birthday, little girl.